Instead of distributing hard copy forms to multiple people for approval, online approvals enabled by Ragic ensure you have proper documentation and save time. In Ragic, you can configure an online approval process for a form, which is flexible and easy to set up. Open the form that you want to add an approval to. Click on Change Design in the upper right corner. Then, hover over the icon in the lower right corner and click Configure Approval Flow for this form. Select Add Approval Step. On the left side, you can fill in the approver department or title so that we can easily identify the approver for this step. From the drop-down menu on the right side, under Name, you can choose the actual person or group that the approval workflow will go to. If you select anyone, the initiator can select any person as the approver when they start the approval workflow. If you select Direct Supervisor under Organizational in the menu, Ragic will automatically set the initiator's direct supervisor as the approver, according to the employee information settings in the User Management menu. You can also add a group or a specific user as an approver. If you need a non-user as an approver, such as a client or supplier, choose Email in the Name dropdown. Now that we've had a short overview, let's try to set one up. As an example, we will look at a leave of absence sheet. The first approval step is going to be the direct supervisor, so under Name, I will select Direct Supervisor under Organizational in the menu. If you only need one approval step, click Save and Exit. However, many approval workflows require more than one approval, so click Add Approval Step. For the second step, I want to set a rule. If the total hours is greater than 3 full working days, which means greater than 24-hour work days, HR approval is required. Enter HR in the step name and choose HR from the drop-down under Name. Click on the gear icon on the right side and choose Set Rules. To create a new rule, click New. Select which field the rule will be dependent on and specify the parameters required to trigger the rule. I have created a rule stating that if total hours are greater than 24, then HR approval is required. Click X to close the pop-up window. Now there are two approval steps in this sheet. First, each record requires approval by the initiator's direct supervisor. Secondly, if the total hours of leave are greater than 24, then HR approval is required. Click on Advanced to see some additional settings. If I check Allow to Reject Approval, a reject button is available during approval flow. If I check Lock Record when approval starts, the record will be locked once the approval process starts, which restricts the initiator from modifying the record while the record is in the approval workflow. Click Save and Exit. Let's practice an approval with our settings. If Kevin applies for 4 days off, it will require HR approval because the total hours are greater than 24. The first approval step is Kevin's direct supervisor, Sally. Sally's name is auto-populated because she is Kevin's direct supervisor in his employee information settings. For the second step, he needs to choose from the available users in the HR group. Then, he clicks the Start Approval button. Sally will receive an email notification with all the information for this request and can directly click Approve or Reject in the email. It will open up a web page for her to type in a reason, which is optional. After the direct supervisor has approved the request, it goes to the HR person that was chosen. In this case, HR is viewing the request in Ragic and can approve directly in the record. These settings are very basic. Let's consider some other situations. If you have several approvers in one step, there may be two different situations. You may require each approver to approve the record, or maybe you only need some approvers from a group to approve. This is a contract sheet for a sales department. The first approval step requires sales manager's approvals. There are two sales managers, William and Eve, and both of them need to approve it before it can go to the next step. Let's go to the design mode and add the approval steps. Click on Change Design in the upper right corner, and then the Approval icon in the lower right corner. Name the first step Sales Manager and choose William as the approver. Then, click on the gear icon on the right side and select Add Approvers in this step. It will create a new box for you to choose another approver, and I will choose Eve here. If you want to add more approvers, you can click on the gear icon and select Add Approvers in this step again. After reading multiple approvers in a step, you can also set a threshold for approval, meaning it only requires some approvers to approve. Let's do an example and add another approval step. The second step will be named Legal Supervisor. There are two legal supervisors, Alan and Michelle, and the approval flow will be completed as long as only one of them approves. I will choose Michelle as the first approver, then click on the gear icon and select Add Approvers in this step. After we add Alan as an approver, click on the gear icon beside Michelle. Select Set a Threshold for Approval. Enter the number 1, which means this approval step will be completed after one user in this step has approved it. Click Save and Exit. Now, let's see how it works. I have entered the sales contract record and I want to initiate the approval process. When I click Start Approval, both of the sales managers, William and Eve, will receive requests for approval through email at the same time. When both of them have approved it, it will automatically proceed to the next approval step, and Michelle and Alan will receive an email. For the second step, only one user is required to approve it. Once either Michelle or Alan has approved it, it will be completed. To get more information, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications for the latest videos. If you have any questions, leave your comments below.